Hello, everybody. Welcome to another episode of Basement Electronics. So today we're going to take a look at Onion's cloud offering. So Onion's the same company that brought us the Onion Omega, and we're going to use, I'm going to use my Onion Omega to connect to their cloud offering. So device clouds have always kind of intrigued me. A lot of cloud offerings that I've seen have been really good for collecting data. So you have your device, for instance, my go-to example is the temperature sensors. So suppose you have an Arduino set up with their temperature sensors, and then you have it connect to a cloud statistics site that will collect your data and then, you know, build graphs and make your data something easy to look at. The Onion Cloud, I don't think does that. So it does provide API keys for your device, but from what I've been able to read so far, just from their on their website and their description, I think it's more of a cloud control, so that you can deploy your Onion Omegas wherever, and then be able to control their function or even compile and upload programs to it from the cloud. Now, up front, I'm going to say this video might be a little short because I'm not entirely sure if there's a whole lot I can do besides demonstrating how to set up the cloud. But I still think that this would be a video worth watching because if you have a distributed set of devices, you still want to be able to control it. It would be nice if, they might have plans for it. I'm definitely not an authority on this, but it would be nice if they did have some sort of data collection plugin for their cloud. So let's get started. So here's the here's Onion's website. Just quick couple blurbs on their cloud offering, and sure enough, as they talk about, they're talking about sending remote commands to your device, cloud compile, so you compile programs and upload it to your device. So for instance, if you want to deploy a new version of your software, you'd be able to build it on the website and send it out instead of needing direct access to your device, which may not always be possible. So we're going to connect into their cloud. Maybe. There we go. So spinning gears. Did that work? Yes. Okay. So when you log in, it's a similar interface to what you see when you connect to their web interface on the actual device. Just as a quick reminder, I'm just going to connect to my local device here. So again, they have like the color gradient, similar login screen. And then the tiles. One thing I also want to point out, one little new feature they have in their latest firmware, you can actually plug a webcam into the Onion Omega. As you can see, very similar interface, so they're consistent. So first thing we're going to do, we're going to register our device. Maybe. Okay, new device. Onion name, name, description, sounds good, create device, I realize I'm showing a secret key on here right now. I will be deleting this account afterwards, so anyone who tries using this key, no. I'm smarter than that. Alright, so they have a nice little tutorial down here. So first connect device profile with physical mega, managing sharing access. Set up code to connect physical mega to the unit device. What? Oh. What? What? Okay, next. Use the setup code. What setup code? And then there are two ways you could also use in command line. I'm going to use a command line because I do not see this one-time setup code. Next. Oh. Of course it restarted. Right, okay. So, how do I get out of here? Oh, exit tour. Set up code. So, we'll do that. No. ZVGWBZVQN. Glad they give me 2 minutes to do this. ZVGWBZVQM. Set up device. What? Why? Says it's online. Yeah. All right, that looks... Oh, right. So share device, I don't actually have... Oh, no, I don't have any other accounts on here. So someone else has an account on the Omega Cloud. You could add their... You can add their email. So... Yeah, invalid me. So yeah, they need an active cloud account. But we now have an active device on the cloud. So go back to the main menu, Device Explorer. And wow, that is a big... Oh, neat. Okay, these are in the way. Why won't these go away? Clicking them. Clicking the X. That's actually minor. That's actually rather annoying. And then key manager. No, sorry, I just realized I might be talking a little low. Oh my goodness, go away. Alright. One sec, I'm gonna be right back. I'm just gonna restart my browser. Okay, we're back now, and I managed to get rid of those status bars up top. And then just to make sure we still have our device logged in. Yes, so it has the little cloud icon, meaning that it sees it. So let's try this. New key. Okay. So we'll copy that. Save changes. Oh, here we go again. I wish it would at least time out. Unfortunately, I don't have a program I can compile on the Omega Handy. Otherwise, I'd show you the compile. Is there like a command back there? Log. Read. So say. 15, run. Is it running? Send command. Device manager. Huh. Well, let's see. Let's go into key manager and see what the tutorial has to say about it. Independent authentication credential is tied to your account but separate from your username and password. Each of your applications can use different keys so you can. Okay. Okay, so this is still a feature in development, I guess. Next, so blah blah. So then we can go in. All right, so I guess in the future you can have applications that will access the cloud, and then you can set permissions depending on what key is used. So that's pretty neat. Of course, once you're done, you can go through, delete your manager. Actually, before I do that, show you a quick look at the cloud compile here. So, create a new project. Project name. Okay, so that's how it works. So you have your .c files, you drag them in, it'll compile it and upload it for you. Shoot, if I was thinking a Hello World C program would be perfect. I'll be right back. All right, so I grabbed a Hello World.c file, and it's pretty simple. So let's... this. What happened? Start new compile. Expecting a zip file. Fine, we can create a zip file. Send to zip folder. Look at that, hello world.c, zip file. Now what? Start compile. So I haven't actually tried this yet. Deploy. Well, let's take a look here. There we go. That's the problem. I forgot to select my device. Now I deploy. Deployed. So now if we take a look at here. Hello world. I forgot to put a slash n on it, but whatever. So imagine instead of just a simple hello world, this is like a service that you have running in the background, grabbing information from the GPIO pins, or such as temperature data or humidity data. Like suppose you have a program collecting data, it's sending information off to wherever you want to send it, and something's not quite working right. Like maybe the timing isn't quite right in your program, or just, you know, something's not right. So you can rewrite the program on your local machine. Go to Onion's cloud service, and then compile it here, and then push it out to your device, and then using the device control, which admittedly I still haven't figured out yet, you can actually have it stop the old one and start the new program. And then where this really comes in handy, suppose you have about 10 devices. Instead of, compiling it on your local machine and then having to copy it all, then like SCP it to all your Onion Omegas, and then start it and stop it, you can do it all from here. So all you would do is, it already has the compile uploaded. So you just select which device you want to deploy to. So changes. Oops, not what I meant to do. So there's Hello World. And then choose your next device, deploy. Next device, deploy. Your next device, deploy. And then go back. Is it this one? No. That one. I really wish this worked. And I promise I'm gonna stop harping on that. So file, execute your commands. Parameters and just run. See? Standard out, hello world. So I guess that is how that works. Alright, that's kind of neat. So I'm going to finish this here. I'll put the hello world up on my GitHub. It's not much. I literally just did a search for hello world C code and then pulled up the first thing. It's about 4 lines. In fact, here. That's all it is. But I'll throw it up in GitHub anyway. Who knows? Maybe someone will want it. I'll also put up a link to Onion's cloud service so that, you know, so that you can take a look. And otherwise, why are you offline? Probably my connection again. But you can play with it and, let me know what kind of success you have. I realize this video is a little bumbling, but that's Onion's Cloud. It really is a great service, and I think definitely has a lot of promise. It does have a little work left to be done. And we know they're still working on it. Like the application API keys. You saw that. So it's all definitely still a work in progress. And if they continue with the quality that they have been showing, because, I really do like the Onion Omega, and like their interface is very clean. It's, like, I like using their web interface for the actual Omega, and I think it's really neat. I really want to grab some of these shields and start playing with them. But I really think this shows a lot of promise. And did this keep my compile? Yep. Ooh. How do I delete a compile? No. Oh, delete project. There. And I guess with the zip files in that too, it would make it easier to have .h files, multiple dot, actually a full C project. So I'm gonna finish this here. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you found that entertaining, if not informational. And I'll see you next time. Goodbye.